fry paneer, start to heat up a pan.
In the heated pan, first I am going to roast the kadhai masala, so that is 10 to 15 black pepper, 1 small stick of cinnamon stick, 2 green cardamom, 1 tablespoon of cumin seeds, 1 tablespoon of fennel seeds, 1 tablespoon of coriander seeds, 4 to 5 cloves. So all I am going to roast in the heated pan. It will just take a minute. Roast it on a medium flame. If you roast it on a high flame, then the masala can get burnt and you will get a spoiled taste into the spices. Stir continuously. After a minute, you will start to get a nice aroma out of the spices. So that is the time, switch off the flame. Let it cool down and then grind it in the grinder to fine powder. You can see the spices have changed its color, especially the cumin seeds and fennel seeds. So just switch off the flame and remove it in a plate. Now in the same pan, I am going to make kadhai paneer. In the heated pan, add around 7 to 8 tablespoons of oil. I am going to fry all the vegetables into it. It is good if you fry all the vegetables so that it retains its crunchiness. Keep the flame on a high heat because all the vegetables will be fried on a high flame. No need to overcook them. It will just take a minute each vegetable. So I am going to use 1 bowl of peppers, 1 bowl of onions and 1 bowl of tomatoes. All are diced in 1 inch size. And around 250 grams of this is paneer. So in the heated oil, just add the onions and fry them till you get a golden texture on the pieces. This should be the texture of the vegetables. At this stage, the vegetables are fried as well as they retain its crunchiness. So now just remove it from the pan. Then goes in the peppers. Just fry them the way onions were done. This should be the texture of the peppers. So I'll remove this too from the oil. Peppers are also done. Then goes in the tomatoes. Just slide them slowly into the oil. Tomatoes will hardly take a minute to get fried. This should be the texture of the tomatoes. So tomatoes are also done. I'll remove it from the oil. Now in the leftover oil, which should be approx 5 to 6 tablespoons, add 2 bay leaves, 2 tablespoons of chopped garlic, 2 tablespoons of chopped ginger and fry them till it loses its aroma. Then add a bowl of finely chopped onion. Fry them till they turn translucent. Then add 2 medium sized onions finely chopped and saute them till they turn very tender and gets a pulpy texture. Add little bit of salt so that the tomatoes gets cooked faster. When the masala is done, just remove it in a plate and let it cool down. Then it will be grinded to a fine paste. This is the roasted spices which has been grinded to form a fine powder. Now in the same pan, add 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil. To that I'll add the grinded paste and saute till it starts to leave oil from the sides. Add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1.5 tablespoon of red chili, Kashmiri red chili powder. Cook the spices along with the paste. Add 3 green chilies slit from the center. Add the dry spices and cook for a minute. Add a cup of water and cook again till it starts to leave oil from the sides. Add all the fried vegetables into the paste and again cook for a minute. I will add the salt at the very last so that the vegetables retain its crunchiness. So that is one more tip while cooking kadhai paneer. After cooking for a minute, add around a half cup of fresh cream and mix it well. Now add the cottage cheese into the pan and mix it well. See to it, each cottage cheese should be well coated with the gravy. Now if you want the gravy to be more thinner, just add a cup of water and let it come to boil. Keep the flame on a medium heat. Finally add salt to taste and mix it well. Garnish with freshly chopped coriander leaves. Mix it well. Finally, crush 1 tablespoon of fenugreek leaves onto the gravy. Mix it well. Kadhai paneer is ready to serve. Serve it with naans, rotis or parathas. This will really taste very delicious. Everyone will enjoy this.